Hey everybody, it's Teph. I just got back from Generation Beauty San Francisco and I thought it would be a lot of fun to do a Generation Beauty haul. And let me tell you, I have a lot of stuff to haul. As always with my Generation Beauty haul videos, please let me know in the comments down below what you would like to see reviews on, because there's no way I could review everything. But I want to make sure I'm giving you the information about the products that, you know, I can, so that you can make informed purchasing decisions yourself. I'd also really appreciate it if you gave this video a thumbs up if you love hauls. And also subscribe to my channel for more makeup, beauty, and lifestyle videos. I'm also gonna be doing a giveaway coming up real soon, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, so you guys get the first notice of that. So let's go ahead and get into the haul. So this time around, I actually almost ended up with too much stuff. And when I say too much stuff, I mean more stuff that I could bring back on the plane. Literally, when I got to the airport, my suitcase was 60 pounds. And they're like, so you either have to pay $50 or remove 10 pounds. And I was afraid I wasn't gonna be able to do it, but I just managed it. When I brought it back up, it was exactly 50 pounds. And the reason for that is that I ended up with two huge bags of stuff. So this is the bag that I got while I was walking around talking to the brands at Generation Beauty. As you can see, the bag is from Eva NYC. I actually had a lot of people asking me where I got the bag. That is what the other side looks like. And the other bag is this one. This bag is really near and dear to my heart because I was lucky enough to get invited to the creator cocktail party on Friday night. And not all creators got invited to this party. I got my invite really last minute, actually. So this was the goodie bag that those creators got who went to that party. Everybody else got different goodie bags and then could get the same things going around. Of course, as a creator, I was also doing networking at Generation Beauty. And some of the things in that bag I'm actually gonna be giving away during that upcoming giveaway I mentioned. So I'll go ahead and point out those items as a little bit of a preview on that. But since it's in my lap already, we're gonna go ahead and start with the creator bag. So I'm gonna go ahead and unzip it, and this is what it looks like inside. And by the way, you saw the front, it says from Ipsy with love. I think that's what it says. Oh yes, I think that's really cute. And I love how the bag zips. It's just a really nice touch. So I'm just gonna be going through this in no particular order. And first at the top is this cute little makeup case. Now you can't see it on it. Oh, it actually has it on here. It's from Jouer. So here you have some brushes in those little pouches. And I love when makeup cases have those little brush areas. And then you also have this smaller case that comes with it, and this has some products in it as well. I'm gonna try to go through these as fast as possible, by the way, because I know from past experiences these videos do tend to get very long. We have a glisten brightening powder, and then we have these four. I'm not gonna open them all, but this one's a longwear lip cream in Cassis, longwear lip cream in Nozette, longwear lip cream in Crowned Rose. I'm completely butchering these names, by the way. And then we also have a longwear lip cream in Buff. And I've actually tried these before. I'm actually wearing a lip cream right now, and they are absolutely amazing. Best longwear lip products I've ever tried. They just feel amazing. They go on. They really do stay on all day, and they're just so cool. Next thing is a box of brushes from Luxe. I'll just go ahead and pull these out and show them to you. They are all face brushes. And that is what those look like. Next, we have a little box from Purelisse. This is the Blue Lotus 4-in-1 Cleansing Milk, which I'm really excited to try. We also have another one of my favorites. It's the Spray It Clean Dry Shampoo from Rock Your Hair. We also got the Deep Cleansing Oil from GHC and the Laneige Water Sleep Mask. I actually had a mini of this from the last GenBeauty I went to, and I really liked it, so I am happy to have the full size. The next one I actually already tried. I just put it back in the box. This is the Royal and Landnickel brush set. So the whole thing, it actually comes with this really cute case, which is gonna look super cute on my vanity. And I actually needed a new brush holder, so this works out very well. So it looks like this. And then you have a little top that has some snaps on it. So in theory, it stays on. And then you have all the brushes. You have some eye brushes, some face brushes. I used this one for blush today, and then I used a couple of others. We have the Skin Fix Renewing Cream. I'm super excited to try this one because it's supposed to help with keratosis pollicis. It's a skin condition that I actually have. You probably noticed my arms are bumpy. Sometimes it's also called chicken skin, but I don't like that name because I'm not a chicken and I do not wish to be a chicken. Anyway, it's a genetic skin condition, and pretty much much nobody knows how to get rid of it. Like, literally, I'm debating having laser hair removal to get rid of this stuff. But first, I want to try this little baby out. See, obviously, this is a lot more of an affordable option versus laser hair removal. I'm really excited to give this one a try. We also have a little one from Organics. This is the, oh, this is what it looks like, by the way. And they put it in this bag. I thought that was so, so clever. So this is the Weightless Oil Lifting Tonic. And we got this huge bag from Beauty Box, if you can see it. So starting on top, we have Botanical Mellow Clay Mask. We have a lot of masks in here, by the way. We have the Botanical Mellow Clay. Oh, I see, they're different. What, they're all, they say the same thing, but they have different colors. What does this mean? Ah! I figured it out. All of them have different clays, and it's in a little tiny writing in the bottom corner right next to my finger. So this one is pink clay. Then we have one that is green clay. And this one is volcanic clay. Powder. That's not clay, that's powder. It also came with this little scrubby to remove the mask, which is really cool because I hate removing those masks, as well as this little adorable headband for masks. I actually bought another one while I was there. This one's a little bear, and you just, you know, I'm not gonna put it on my head, but you put it on your head and you get to be a little bear while you're doing your masks, and you get to be so cute. They also sent along this little thing, which looks like it's some sort of spatula. Oh, I need to open this. Okay, looks like it's some sort of spatula that you can use to apply the mask, which is super clever. I usually just do it with my fingers. This would be so much less messy, and it's silicone, so it's bendable, and you can, you know, put it on and use it to put it on your face, and oh, such a good idea. And then last we have a bunch of sheet masks. And if you've been around here for a while, you know I love sheet masks. So we have the That Day, oh, they're all That Day mask packs. Okay, I have no idea what the difference is between these. Oh, this is hydrating care, brightening care, blemish care. Then these next ones are botanical mask packs. This one is a nectarine, I don't know what that is, and lime. Then we have an Acinozy and acai berry. I'm terrible at pronunciation, by the way. We have a chamomile and green tea. That one I can pronounce. Oh, collagen and olive. Sodium hyaluronate and lotus. And, oh my goodness, I want to say mosquito, but it's so not mosquito. Macedonicide and mugwort. This next item is from Vital Proteins. It's a drinkable collagen powder, I believe. It has no taste, and it's supposed to help prevent wrinkles or even get rid of wrinkles. Now, I'm 27, so that's something I do have to start thinking about, and I've heard good things about this, so I'm really excited to give this little baby a try. We also got this little pack from NYX, which I should open. Probably should have done that for time before the video, but whatever. First, we have a NYX Lip of the Day lip product. It looks like it's a highlighter, if you can see that. Ha-ha. We also have a NYX Plush Gel Lipstick in a color I'll probably never wear, as well as a contour palette. Let's see if I can bust this thing open and show you what it looks like. I'm opening my drawer. So here's the palette. It's called Love Contours All, which is just adorable. And then we open it up, and here's the palette. It looks like these are like contours, and the rest of them are actually like eyeshadow type contour shades. A lot of them are sparkly. So I thought it was like a contour instead of an eye contour, but I'll actually use this one a little bit more. So I'm excited about that. I do love NYX products, and I feel like usually their shadows have really good quality. We also have a red NYX Plush Gel Lipstick in addition to that really light one. And then two NYX pigments. Let's see, this one is 18 and this one is 40. I don't think they used to call them pigments, but they used to call them like loose eye powders. And I have a ton of these, so I'm really excited to try the pigment versions. As you can see, we have my absolute favorite product of all time. Not, it's the Their Real Mascara by Benefit. This stuff is one of those products you either love it or hate it, and I happen to fall on the hating it camp. So you'll probably see this one sometime in an upcoming giveaway. I don't know if I got this one in this bag or if it was actually given to me in Generation Beauty. I actually had to unpack the bags to bring everything back, so I had to like resort. But anyway, this is the Derma E Toner Mist, and I really like this stuff. I actually am using a lot of Derma E products at the moment. Next is these Triple Threat Mascara from Pure. Now that I think about this, I think this one might have been given away at the actual event and not in the bag. We also have a Crown Volumizing Mascara, as well as the TARDIS Mascara from Tarte. And last in this bag, we have four powdered eyeshadows from Absolute. This one is, let's see, jeweled. It's kind of a brown color. Then we have Mahogany, so obviously like a little bit more of a reddish brown. We have this blue one, which is gunmetal, so I guess probably more gray. And then a purple one called Polish Plum. Now it is time for the second bag, the things that I got while at Generation Beauty at the different booths. There are a couple things I purchased. I'll mention those as I go along. I also got some of these items when I talked to brands, and they weren't always the items that were given to everybody as normal, so I just wanted to kind of disclose that up front. First was something that I bought. This is from Pure, and this is the Love Your Selfie 2 palette. I'm actually wearing these shadows on my eyes today, and I have to say they're really gorgeous. This is what the palette looks like. Like, you also get two lip products and a mascara, which I did not use. I also purchased their little sponge, kind of like a beauty blender. It's denser than the beauty blender, but the reason why I wanted to try it is because of the flat side. I thought that was very interesting. I also got a few things from the Balm, and when I mean a few things, when I say a few things, I mean a lot of things. My first item is actually one that you will be able to win very soon in an upcoming giveaway. This is the Bon Appetit palette, and the shadows are, you probably can't see that, but they're in the shapes of the words eat your heart out, which is adorable. So keep an eye on my channel to be able to win this baby in the next few weeks. That's gonna be super exciting. The Bon also gave me some stuff to try. So there's the La Bomba palette. This is an eyeshadow palette. We also have, what is this? Sexy Mama. This is a powder. I don't know if it's a translucent or a very light powder, but regardless, I am very pale, so it works very well for me. We also have Cabana Boy, which I believe is a blush. A bunch of these are blushes, and then one of them's a bronzer. So then we have Bomba Mama. I think this one's the bronzer and the rest of them are blushes. We have Down Boy. This one's a blush. That was a very odd angle. And then I think there's one more of those small ones, but it's hidden. There's also the Matrimony palette. This is really adorable. I've actually used it and I like these mattes. The bag is like falling. It's not working out so well. Let's see if we can keep this on my lap. So I'll just kind of open this little baby up. And I think this is so cute. So it's called the Meet Matrimony palette. And these are what the shadows looks like. And they're all named, they're all like matte, like guy names. So there's Matt Lynn, Matt Thomas, Matt Kumar. It's just really adorable. And the shadows, I mean, there's a very good range. So far, I've only used it once. I was very disappointed with the black, but I'm sure with, you know, you could layer it without a problem, but still with the black, kind of has to be really pigmented. Other than that, so far, I am very happy with the palette. Also from the Pure Lease booth, they gave us a full box of the Blue Lotus and Seaweed sheet masks. I've tried these before and they are absolutely amazing. I love them. We also have a bunch of Pixi products. The first one is one that I bought myself. This is the Pixi Glow Peel Pads. I've actually had my eye on these for a while and they had a discount at GenBeauty, so I bought them and decided to give them a try. By the way, I have a bunch of other Pixi products. I'll go through as many of them as I can right now, but they'll probably be a little scattered about. I got some of them from the booth, but some of them I got from a beauty creator who works with Pixi, who I had dinner with. She had more products than I think she thought she could use, so she was, you know, giving them to some people at the table. I don't want to say who she was, just because I don't know if she'd be cool with that. Anyway, I just wanted to disclose that I got some of that stuff from somebody else. So this is the, what is it, the Large Lash Mascara from Pixi. We also have, there it is, the Lengthy Fiber Lash Mascara. This next one I did get from her, definitely. The rest of them, I don't remember if I got them at the booth or from her. But this is the Fairy Dust Favorites. It's part of their holiday collection, and it's a group, I believe, all of matte loose pigment shadows. I did try these and they work amazingly well. They're just a little messy because the top of one is the bottom of the next. So you just kind of have to be careful as you're using them, but that's kind of how it is for a lot of, you know, those type of powder shadows. We also have a little color correcting quad from Pixi. I've actually been needing a color correcting quad for a while, so that worked out well. We also have a little Pixi lipstick. This one, it looks like, is pretty red, but the glare is such that I can't really read the name on it, so sorry about that one. And I think that's all the Pixi I can find at the moment. We do have a lot of Physicians Formula here though. So we have the Physicians Formula Super BB Filter BB, Filter BB Bronzer. That's what that looks like, if you can see it through the probable glare of the lights. We also have the Beauty Balm BB Cream. This one I believe is in light medium. I actually, now that I think about it, I got this one in the creator bag because I remember thinking, ah, damn it, I wish they had light, and we like all checked and everybody got the same shade. Only worked, I don't think it actually worked really well for anybody in the group, which was kind of a shame, but whatever. We also got the Contour Trio BB Stick. This one's like a blush and highlighter one, which is really cool. And there's another one that is more of your highlight and contour shades. The idea is that you stroke it on once and then you just like blend it out with a sponge or something like that, and you don't need a whole bunch of different products, and it's super easy to apply. The next items were donated for my upcoming giveaway by Eva NYC. We have the Freshen Up Dry Shampoo in a full size, and then also the Forget Me Not Dry Conditioner, again in the full size. So one lucky winner is going to be winning this duo. Shea Moisture sent out this little pouch. I have to hold this on my lap, otherwise it's gonna fall off, so I don't really have hands. But there is a conditioner, a shampoo, and a body wash in here. And they're like really good sizes. They're like more than deluxe samples, but less than full sizes, obviously. I also have another Tarte mascara from Tarte. This one is out of the box. This is the one they were giving away to attendees. I feel like it would have been cool if they had the boxes, but maybe they were just trying to save it for space. I don't know. Next is adorable. I think I mentioned that I bought one of these headbands and it's little kitty ears. Can you see? The only thing that would have been cuter is if they had either black or tabby, because my cats are black and tabby. Fun story, I got my black cat Opal on sale. She was 50% off, and then she had to have emergency surgery 2 days later, but I still love her. Anyway, next in the bag is a Shimmer Glam makeup sponge, and this brand is actually started by a YouTuber, so I'm really excited to try that out. I also have a couple of brushes from hers in here, but I think they're kind of, oh no, here's one of them. Right here, it looks like this is a like a crease or a blending brush. And then we also have a Luxie brush right here as well. Now, speaking of brushes, we have a little set from Crown Brush. And this is actually one of my most disappointing experiences. Like, if you've ever seen Crown Brush, they usually have really good quality, but these are definitely not good quality travel brushes. Like, you can just see it through the brushes, like the bristles. They're just not soft, they're not dense, it's just not a good set. And it's really a shame because it seems like Crown Brush just kind of went cheap on the stuff they were giving away. Anyway, that just made me really frustrated at Crown Brush. They've been there a few times. They a lot of times don't even give away anything. And then when they do give away something, it's just like this little cheap thing. It's like, oh, don't even pretend, right? We have a little baby dry shampoo from Rock Your Hair. I always love travel sizes, so that's good. We're starting to get into the smaller products that went to the bottom of the bag. So there are gonna be a lot of small ones here. So this is the Physicians Formula Filter Trio BB Powder. I'm a little bit worried about this one just because it's a little dark for me. On here it says nude filter, healthy glow in sunset. Maybe I could use this as like bronzer or something, because I definitely could not use it all over. Next is a Pop Beauty mascara. This one is called Permanent Pout. Oh no, it's not a mascara, it is a lip paint. And that is the color right there. GHG was giving out an advanced split end therapy, which is really nice. I think I really need it. Need a haircut actually, but I don't want to cut my hair because I don't want to lose length. So something like that is really the next best thing. Two more, if I can hold them up, of those little Korean clay masks. I think this one is the pink clay, and I don't remember which one the blue one is, but two little minis of that. Then from Shea Moisture, we have a little eyeshadow palette. And in hindsight, I think this one may have been in the creator bag as well. So from Eva NYC, I have a therapy session hair mask, which I'm excited to try. I want to see if my hair will take it because I have very oily hair. And I've recently made some changes to my hair routine that have been helping so far and may mean that I will be able to use deep conditioning treatments and actually, you know, use treatments that are healthy for my hair again, because previously I could not, otherwise it would be really, really dry. Anyway, so we have a Derma E Purifying Daily Detox Scrub. I love this product. Then I'm just kind of pulling a few things out at a time. We have a Pixie lipstick. This is a red color. Maybe you can see that, maybe you can't. And then this is the Pop Mascara I remembered getting. And this is called Lashy Flashy Mascara. I found another blush from the balm. This is Frat Boy. And since I was a sorority girl, like, it holds a good place, a little special place in my heart. But at the same time, they like to be called fraternities and not frats, but whatever, we still all call them frats anyway. Anyway, Milani gave me a few of their different lipsticks. So this one is a matte lipstick, more matte in red, is sort of the lip cream in Amore. So let me see, we have another more matte lipstick. This one is in Sweetie. This is a like a nude pink color, what I like to call a true nude, because it's actually kind of like your lips but better. Anyway, we have another lip product from Pixie. And a little Freshen Up Dry Shampoo from Eva NYC. Little mini deer. So really adorable. We also have a couple of, what are these called? Batter Up Eyeshadow Sticks from the Balm. We have Sugar and Dugout. So those are those. Again, I have to hold the bag with one hand, otherwise it's gonna fall on the floor. So that's why my angles are kind of awkward here. This is the Surf's Up Texture Spray for Eva NYC. Kind of excited and kind of scared to try that one. Then next we have the Pop Beauty Nail Polish. This is a purple color. It is called 67 and it is gorgeous. I love purple and I love nail polish, so those kind of go together well. And I just grabbed a bunch of lip products, so we're gonna kind of go through all of them. So we have another Milani Amore Matte. This one is in Darling. I think I got two Darlings, so that's okay. We have a Velvet Lippy from Absolute in Fatale. Beautiful red, dark red color. And this one's also from Absolute, another Velvet Lippy in Flamingo. I think Flamingo would be a little bit brighter pink, but that's okay. It's a beautiful color. And I have a hair in my mouth, so let's just go ahead and take care of that and just rearrange the hair. We have an Amore Metallic from Milani in, let's see, Materialistic, I believe is what it is called. And then this one is an eye pencil from Nude Sticks. It is, it says it's shimmer. I can't find a shade, so it's a shimmer eye pencil from Nude Sticks that I'm actually quite excited to try. Don't mean that like me making fun of it is me, I'm not excited to try it. Next out is a Spotlight Primer from Absolute. Magnetic Matte Eye Color from Nude Sticks. Very gorgeous. Here we go. Here's the rest of them. So a more matte metallic lip cream. That's interesting. Matte and metallic. This is Chromatic Addict. Love that name. Very beautiful. We have another Pure Metal Veil from Absolute. This one is in Mahogany. A Milani Amore Matte Metallic Lip Cream. This one in Materialistic. Then we have a Shea Moisture lipstick. It's a red color. Let's see if I can figure out what the name is. It's Poppy. Little mini fully charged mascara from Pure. I love little mini mascaras. Then we have a little baby Jouer lip cream and the color is Noisette. It's like a brown color. Very interesting. And then another Pure Mineral Veil from Absolute. I found one more item in there. We have another sheet mask. This is the I can't even pronounce that, and acai berry. Anyway, that is the very last product in there. And oh my goodness. I just wanna say, I thank you so much for supporting my channel. And you might say like, oh, that's so out of left field, but here's the thing. I got at least half of the stuff I did at Generation Beauty to try out because of you guys, because I'm a creator, because you're here supporting my channel, watching and subscribing and liking and commenting. So, I mean, I have this opportunity to try all these products because of you guys. So thank you so, so much for that. I can't even express how much you mean to me, how much this channel means to me, and being on YouTube, I mean, it's almost my 3-year anniversary, and it has been a crazy, amazing journey. So thank you so, so much. Again, I know that was a little out of left field, but I couldn't not say it. I mean, it's just amazing. I can't even think of where to start. I mean, that's like the best problem to have, right? Anyway, please remember to comment down below letting me know which of these products you'd like me to review. Obviously, I can't get to everything, but I want to make sure that I am focusing in on the products that you would like to see. And then the other ones, a lot of them will probably show up in favorites videos and tutorials and other things like that. So go ahead and keep an eye out for that. Also, please give this video a thumbs up. Those really make my day. And make sure to subscribe not only for more makeup, beauty, and lifestyle videos, but also to be notified when that giveaway that I talked about goes live. And I will see you next time. Bye.